Hello, everybody. This is Dark Rage TV, and you're watching an episode of Subnautica. Today, we're starting over. I had a lot of footage, but it's kind of put me to sleep when I was watching it. So, we're going to start a new game. I have gone to Freedom level, I believe. It's basically the same thing as Survival, but no food and water required, which is a huge plus if you start watching. And here's the intro.
Attention.
Hull failure imminent. Personnel abandon ship.
Launch in
3, 2, 1. Now, my question, I'm flying away from this ship. It can't just stay up straight in the sky. It should be moving. So how am I landing where it's landing? That's what I don't understand. Actually, for a few miles with it, minimum. Oh! Ouch. That hurt. Okay. Let me out. Let me out. Let me out. There you go. The fire. The fire extinguisher. For a while, we'll put that away. Flare. Okay, so you open this up, we open your storage up, you start out with two flares.
Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation.
Filter
of the
water.
Dark matter drive core okay. Due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor.
Okay. Need repair tool. Need repair tool. Okay. That's supposed to initialize my PDA. I guess I overrode that when I did that. Okay, I gotta repair it first, I guess. Escape pod, how are we looking? Nice, okay. Ooh, back with those guys next to us again. This is what bothers me is that this ship landed right next door to me. Next year, I landed long before the ship. I launched first. That should have shoved me way out there. Because it decided to land right next to me. But why it landed next to me? Because those thrusters should have been pushing it along the sky. In free fall, if they had control of the engines, they just fly away. But they didn't. They blew onto the planet. It should have been miles away. Anyways. Okay, quartz. A few of these.
New creature discovered.
Yes, we did need oxygen, unfortunately.
Caution. Continued degradation of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. Calculating risk assessment.
Yeah,
death by
thing.
Malnourishment,
she
7%.
Beat up a little bit.
By physical injury, 11%. By exposure to
radioactive
crash site
yep.
materials,
surprisingly.
19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases
Opinion.
To 65%.
Copper. Crystals. A little bit of lag. Now, I am playing this in highest settings on a GTX 1060. 3 gig. Yeah, and it blew the 3 gig model out to 6.
Oxygen.
Yep, oxygen. Now they haven't proved the lady. I mean, she was really annoying. Her voice was the same, but It kept repeating, you have 3 seconds, you have 2 seconds, you have one. Like, shut up, I know this. I love these little brain corals, they call them. Whoop! 44 and 45. Okay, up on oxygen. Yeah, we'll go this way. Now, I've watched others play. I used to play this a long time ago before all this ship explosion and whatnot came into the game, which I guess they has definitely added to the content. And I watch other players play. I don't like, honestly, I mean, granted, it's a matter of opinion, but I don't like how they just boof we're here and boof we're there. I hate playing games or watching games to me where I don't know how they did something. Like, you walk into their base, all of a sudden, bam, they've got all this stuff here, and it's like, how do they get it?
Degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%.
Uh-oh.
Advise observing a 1 kilometer safety range.
Oh no.
Oxygen.
It's gonna blow up. Right by it. Oh no! Run! Whoa! I love these guys. Oh, he actually hit me. I got his crash powder anyways. Now we're... You guys here, they're... See, they're just bottom feeders. You can't do anything with them. Oh, an egg already. Lead.
Oxygen.
Oxygen, oh no. We should be able to make it. Oh, we'll jump to 3? To 0, come on, make it, make it, make it, make it, make it, make it! Ah! Woo!
Emergency. Seismic readings suggest a quantum detonation has occurred in the Aurora's drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state. In T minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5,
up,
4, 3,
2, 1. This is that Tony Stark firing off the Jericho missiles moment where it just kind of blows everything back a little bit. A bit of radiation. There we go. All right. So that's done. Yeah. My poor ship. Can I not get this? There we go. Personal tools. Flare. Okay, I need magnesium. Your chip would mean silver and all that stuff. Silicone rubber. I get silicone rubber from... I don't remember. Creepvine clusters. Okay. Okay, make titanium. Titanium and more titanium. Okay. Drop off some of this stuff. Where's the glass? Okay. Alrighty, so we're gonna go. Didn't nighttime? Yes, comes quick. Yeah, those cool guys. They're good to watch. Okay, this is gonna be a little bit dangerous because there's monsters live down here. But we need the pods. I don't see any yellow in there. There's some. Quick as we can, get this. Anything after me yet? Much as yet, okay. All right. Get our first thing, the survival knife. Yay! Back our ship, make us some silicon, make some titanium, and we got ourselves our knife. Now this is still early access, obviously, you see it in the right hand corner. So, you know, expect some bugs. Okay, we'll pull up number five. So we need a... Come on. Lubricant, no. Lubricant we use later on. Personal. Ooh, I can make fins. Final knife. And what I need for an air tank is glass. Which I have! Make more silicon. Then we'll go down here. Make our air tank, which gives a little more air time down there from 45 to 75. Okay. Fins. Have our fins, we have our air tank. I like how they have this man now. You just carried this up in your inventory before. I think your inventory's a bit bigger, wasn't it? No, I think not. Okay, so we have our survival knife, number one thing. Okay. Glass away, that away. Okay. Equipment is. I don't do pipes. I already have a fire signature. First aid kit I don't need because I can get it for free at the moment. Radiant sheet we're going to need. We have lead, I think, already. We have two or one? One. Okay. So, we have that. So we're going to need another lead and some fiber mesh. Fiber mesh is done by creeper vines, I believe. Miss it. Glass, please. Magnesium from salt deposits. Electronics. Chip wiring kit. How did I make fiber mesh? Forgot. I guess I have to learn it first. Yeah, some of these RPGs you don't find out about until you. Did you see that? They're birds! Bird! Probably vultures, right? They want to eat up my corpse. That's okay. See, that means there's an island around here. And the biomes are set now, I guess, permanently. Okay. So we need to head back over there again. We need some creeper vines. That's why we have our handy-dandy knife here. Whoa, guys, come on. Quit blowing up. As you find products and you learn about their thing to be used for. I just given all knowledge of this planet. See? More of this and we'll be happier. Okay, we're full up. Head back to our little life pod. Inventory secured, it says. Every time you enter, it saves. Every time you leave, it saves. So if you die out there, you come back with whatever you have when you left, but not what you found. But knowledge and blueprints, I believe that stays. Flutter mesh! How many do I need? A wiring kit. Dive reel. That's like a find my way back out of a cave type thing. What was I looking for? Repair tool, magnesium and crash fish powder. I have that. Or I can get that. Do-do-do. Okay. Use it all up. Okay, we still need two leads still. So, okay. Can I build a thing yet? Deployables, yes. Okay. Put our little locker on the ground here. Locker, we'll put our mesh in there. One of the last pieces. I think about this stuff here. If you're eating survival, you can't. Well, you could eat it before. Last episode it was. I don't have food now. Maybe that's a problem. But yeah, you could eat that stuff in the other game. So if worse came to worse, that's what you could do. Okay, so I'll look for salt and lead. And anything else. Titanium. Been here, right? We've been there. We want salt. Salt and lead. Another egg. One space, I'll take them. Been here before, we need to actually check it out. Once you get the scanner, you'll find parts scatter around to make blueprints off of. I mean, you need like 3 or 4 pieces to make a single blueprint, which is unfortunate. Okay. There you go, you're that bottom feeder. Titanium, we will need this. The junk piece of the floor. You can turn those into
30 seconds.
Yeah, you can turn those into titanium. Okay, head out this way. Can't get too close to the ship because it's radiation now. Salt deposit! Yay! Keep away from these guys, they drop those little cluster bombs on you. These guys here are pretty cool. You can use those to float things. And when there's enough of them there, they'll actually pull it up. Hi, Gary. Quick oxygen here.
30 seconds.
39, actually. All right, anything in here? Second piece of lead. Okay, we build a radiation suit. Say, radiation detected. We're dying from that stuff. I didn't even notice it before. There's no more when you're at it, you know? Which there should be. You just get a little radiation Geiger counter sound when you're near radiation. No, it doesn't. So you gotta watch for it, I guess. 14% health. Titanium. It's always useful. Best you start building a base, you're gonna need titanium. As you can build habitats in here. Inventory secured. I got that. Jewels. I need a little more salt. One more salt. Okay. No, I didn't. Come on. There we go. Throw the eggs in there. Copper ore in there. And some more titanium. Throw that out. I'm going to use and get more. Okay. Where's my fiber mesh? Tell me it's in the other one. Did I miss it? Yep. Okay. Personal equipment. Radiation suit. Yay! No more death by radiation. Okay, this thing, yes, good. Takes some time for him to generate a new one. So we're still looking for a little bit of salt. And anything else we can find this nice and easy to get? Lead. Copper. Copper. I'd like to find silver, but that's not in this biome. It's going to be in a more dangerous biome. Which kind of sucks. Now we're wearing our radiation suit. So you think they could go to that ship right now, but unfortunately, I don't want to go until I have the ability to scan things. That's kind of the main point of going there. That I need a repair tool to actually fix the ship. But there's not much point. Come on, come on, more, please. More, please. Thank you. What is this? I haven't seen it before. Okay, well. Oh. Nope. The blue part is egg. Bummer. Back to the surface. Get our bearings on that thing right there. Still need a piece of salt, guys. This part that I know gets boring, you know. At least you can see how it happens, what happens, kind of things you have to go through. Because it didn't just simply go up one episode and there's all the stuff you found. There's effort you gotta put out. And salt we got two salt now. Really need what? I see those guys are cool. Reef backs. They are freaking wicked.
Thirty seconds
of oxygen remaining. We might find sewer down there, but that's gonna be kind of dangerous to get to. Not because of him, though. He's cool. He's a non-violent creature. Because of others that lives down there. They're not so friendly. What are you? Just titanium. Just more titanium. Around the edge, just hoping I can find something before I go down in there. I don't really want to go down in there. It's a bit dangerous. Whoa, you guys. They aren't violent, they drop those little gas pods on you. And then we have salt. Okay. In the survival game, you can use salt to cure your food, which gives you a little more nutrition and stuff out of it, I guess. Well, we're down there pretty good, aren't we? But this part of the game is just used for crafting. Eating food and water does not restore your health. You do need med kits for that. And some of the stuff you can scan when you have a scanner. You get blueprints, like I said. I don't know what it is now, because I have a scanner. When you have a scanner, in the bottom right-hand corner, a little scanner icon will show up when you actually are facing and pointing at something that can be scanned. And you just pull your scanner and you, of course, scan it, and it gives you blueprint part pieces. Take a risk. I can find anything down here. I want a piece of silver if I can get it. You're not what I'm worried about, though. I'm not in your territory, that's why. Nighttime's coming. See how these guys are like cold blue. It's so cold. Alright, well, we're getting a repair tool set up. We are going to need that. Where's the ship? Oh, duh. What you got left? Oh, nothing. Now you have your knife, you can get common coral samples. Yes, there's a difference between the purple, the red, and the common. They're each different things. The jeweled one, I believe, too. None of the actual jewels in it, guys. No diamonds or rubies and stuff. Just call jewel. Come on, let me in. There we go. Alright. What do we got here? Make bleach. Bleach is used to make water. But since we don't have no fluid requirements, we can't make that. Yes, bleach to create, make water. Isn't that weird? Yes, yeah, oh, advanced wiring crew requires gold. Wiring kit, which is necessary for the welding machine and the scanner, requires silver. I just need magnesium now. My three salt deposits. And then you got crash fish powder. Tools. And we have a repair tool. Now it does use battery power, but you start with a full charge. Now we'll repair this. There we go. But these have self-charging power cells, so why can't we get those? I'll rip those things out and take them with me. But you can't. Repair this. Our communications unit.
Captain, a new message has arrived.
Uh-oh. It's already got a message, you know, it's offline. Weird.
Bounce back from the Aurora mining vessel. Your distress signal has been received. An emergency relief team will be dispatched to your location. Estimated arrival time 9999 hours.
Captain, we're saved. Only 9999 hours to wait. See the little green icon up in the right hand corner? Means you got a message in your system. It's back to that. Like voicemail. This is LifePod 17, coordinates attached. Looks like the forward Seamouth Bay collapsed around me. Do not attempt me without razor cutters. You only added the body count. LifePod 17 out. And gave us a little signal thing. Now, look around us. Woohoo! 16 away. But they say we would need cutters, which are here. I can find it right first shot. Nope. Go ahead, put it bottom. Needs a diamond and a battery. And believe it or not, they'll actually be fairly common at some point, just like in real life. So, do we go visit that, or do we collect more stuff? We're pretty full on a lot of things, so we need to make another chest. Yeah. Uh-oh, my inventory's full. Open. I have some space. Okay. Really? Okay. But I can't do anything. Okay. And plop. Open. And dump this stuff into it as much as we can. Back to our supplies again. Back in here. Come on. Titanium. Titanium. Can't get that anymore. So deployables. Another chest. Alright. Looks like our chest. Open. And da 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 da. Blueprints. All these things. Secured. And cooked. Cooked is just laser grilled, you know. Cured is when you salt with it. I actually don't know what the difference is by much. There's obviously a difference, you know. Nine hours. These are all your logs and stuff. Your data bank. To birth. But I only see chairs. How's that a birth? Do I lay on the floor here and here or what? I don't know. Anyways, we'll find out at some point, I'm sure. That doesn't seem actually done anything. 62, 63. I want those self-charging pods. But no. Apparently I don't know how to make those. Nah. It's Dark Rage TV, but watching Subnautica. Available on Steam, early access. Check it out, cool game. Subscribe, like, dislike, hit the comment section. If you feel great, tell your friends, spread the word. Until next time, thanks for playing.